This program is brought to you by the following sponsors.
I'll protect you all from the madness of this world. I'll take you to a place where you can be at peace. Yes, it's much more peaceful than here.
I'll hold on to this. Now speak up. What have you gotten yourself into? What was that warning letter about? Why would you be sent something like that? Persona? People going inside a TV? I thought you'd finally tell me what's really going on here. Enough! That's enough! I guess half a year wasn't long enough for you to trust me like your old man, but I'd hoped you'd open up to me a little. It's a shame. Stay here for the night.
Whoa, sorry. Dang, go inside TVs and personas, huh? Well, you can't blame him. I mean, sure, I want to believe you. And I know Dojima-san brought you here and asked you those questions because he wants to believe you too. Plus, you know, you'll be safe here. He probably freaked out once he saw that letter and thought he had to protect you. Like what a father would do for his son. I think he cares for you a lot. So yeah, don't take it so hard. You know, Dojima-san started looking into people involved with the first case again. Guess he wasn't satisfied with the way the case wrapped up after all. That's why he's even more sensitive about this and that. I better shut up now before I get chewed out again. Alright, I'll be just outside. If you need anything, let me know.
Why do I have to pitch in with stock duty?
It's because I'm not working hard enough. There's no getting around it.
And you're proud of that because... Why am I taking care of you anyways? I shouldn't have bought you this. Hang on to it, okay? It's your own cell.
I've entered the information age!
We'd get worried if we couldn't reach you. It's just a cheap kid's model, though.
Thank you, Yosuke.
So to use it, press this button. Scrap that. Watch, I'll show you how I use mine. He's not picking up. It's raining right now, so I was gonna remind him about the midnight channel. Does he not hear it because he's out?
I want to go to Nana-chan's place. I promised to play with her lots.
We're not going. And go put those snacks back. It's already dinner time, so save them for your next visit. Oh, I get you. If he's out, that means Nanako-chan might be home alone.
I feel bad to think of her staying home all alone. We could go take her some dinner. Please, 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 please!
Okay, okay, I hear you. Jeez.
So we can go? Sweet! You're so mature, Yosuke. My heart just skipped a beat because of your thoughtfulness.
Hang on a sec, I'll try calling again. He's still not picking up. Oh, duh, I forgot to try his home line. Hey, Nanako-chan? Is your brother home?
No. He got a weird letter, and Dad saw it and got angry. He took Big Bro to the police station.
Wait, what? He got taken to the police station?
Stop blabbering and let me talk too! Good evening. This is your Teddy speaking. Let's get together and eat snacks again!
Weird letter.
We'll go check up on your brother and dad. So don't worry, okay?
Wait, was it another warning letter? Did he get a second one? And Dojima-san saw that, so he took him to the station? Teddy, give me the phone back. I need to call the others.
I know what you're thinking, but Nanako-chan does fit the pattern. She wasn't seen, but she was heard.
What?!
Do you remember the politician who visited a local school and made the news several times? In those interviews, he always quoted a particular student he spoke with. The child became well-known while remaining anonymous. That girl was Nanako-chan. A reporter who took interest in this released her photo and interview using her real name in today's evening paper. But even before that, this is a small rural town. Her identity must have been circulating for quite some time.
Oh my god!
I should have realized it much sooner, but I was hung up on the idea of people who were shown on TV. It didn't occur to me that this would qualify.
What are we gonna do? Nanako-chan's home alone right now, isn't she?
I'm on my way there as we speak to check on her. Yosuke-senpai is heading to the police station. He said he called Kanji-kun too. They'll explain the situation there.
I'll join them right away, and I'll let Yukiko and Risei-chan know!
Yes, please do!
Hmm? What are you guys doing here?
Hey, what do you think you're doing? I didn't say you could go in there!
Nanako-chan's missing!
What? What do you mean?
Naoto's on the phone, calling from Nanako-chan, your house.
Shiragane, you there? What the hell's going on?
I'm at your house right now. The front door is open and there's no one inside. I'm afraid that Nanako-chan has been kidnapped by our serial killer. Surely you must have known, Dojima-san. The case isn't over yet.
This is the KJ Customer Service Center. The number you have dialed is unavailable right now. The phone may be switched off or outside our coverage area.
Nanako.
Dojima-san.
Is this true? Has Nanako really been... Why? Why Nanako?
It's probably because the media...
What are you doing?
Traffic Division, Ota speaking.
There's been a kidnapping. Get your men on it immediately. Start with checkpoints along the highway.
Checkpoints? Could you explain the situation a little more?
Quit griping and get to it! The victim's a 7-year-old girl. My daughter!
Your daughter? Wait, what about the scene? What makes you think this is a kidnapping?
That's... Look, this could be connected to that multiple murder case.
Connected? But we caught the killer. How long has she been missing? Have you received any notices or ransom letters?
No, but... Damn it, there's no time for this right now!
Alright. I'll try contacting each of the departments.
Even if you tell them this is connected to the murders, we can't prove it. And everyone on the force thinks this case is over and done with. Where are you going?
I'm gonna go look for my daughter. If this is connected to that murder case, the top brass won't accept the facts until it's too late. I'm not gonna wait for those clowns.
But do you even have any ideas or leads on who took her? If they used a car, there's no way...
Shut up! That's why I'm hurrying!
What am I gonna do? Dojima-san's run off half-cocked.
Adachi-san, we'll go look for her too. So please, let him go!
Huh? You know I can't.
So what's going on?
Whoa, hey! If I let all you guys in here, then I'm really in trouble. Besides, we don't even know if this thing's...
Quit your bitching! Now ain't the time for that shit! The hell are we sitting here for when this guy's family's in danger? You gonna own up if something happens? Huh?
Kaji-kun!
I know how you feel, but if you don't tell me what's going on, there's really nothing I can do.
Ah, so you agree to release him once we explain the situation? Very well, then.
No, that's not what I meant.
In any case, if we run out blindly, we'll have no idea where to begin. Let's all take a moment to stop and sort out the situation. Perhaps this will help Adachi-san understand as well. There's no doubt in my mind that this is a kidnapping by the same culprit who was behind the others. Now, consider that the front door at Nanako-chan's house was open. I examined it and found no trace that entry had been forced.
You mean, Nanako-chan opened the door herself?
Precisely. The culprit didn't sneak in. He came boldly up to the front door and pressed the doorbell.
Like how it was for all of us.
For all of us?
But the circumstances are different for her, as compared to us. Remember what Nanako-chan said when we were at the hot springs? I always do what my dad tells me, like not opening the door for strangers.
So is the killer someone Nana-chan knows?
Senpai, do you have any insight into this possibility?
I don't think we can limit ourselves to people Nanako-chan knows.
I agree. Then let us change our perspective slightly. We know for certain that the culprit must be using a large screen TV.
Huh? TV? What?
Each victim was taken at a different scene, yet was thrown into a TV almost immediately after being kidnapped. I would go as far as to say that it took place in front of their houses. Therefore, the culprit must be taking a TV with him as he goes.
You think he's using a car?
Given the efficiency of the culprit's methods, I would assume a vehicle larger than a sedan. However, no unusual vehicles have been sighted. I'd expect someone to notice, since most of the victims vanished during the day.
So it's someone Nanako-chan knows who has a car, but it's a car that can't be seen?
I think we can rule out the possibility that no one happened to see the vehicle, especially since it's happened so many times now.
A car no one would notice? Is there such a thing? What would it be?
That's right. Now I remember. A delivery came. It was a delivery truck!
No one looks twice at a delivery truck, no matter where it's parked.
And if it were a local company, it'd be the same delivery man every time, so he's not a stranger to Nanako-chan. She must have received packages from him during the times she was home alone, meaning we wouldn't know his face. Adachi-san, is there anyone who fits this profile?
A profile formed by a bunch of kids talking it over? Let's see. A delivery company, huh? I don't know. Take it from a detective. I think this is gonna be a lot more difficult than... Hey! Maybe you're not too far off base. Dojima-san put this stuff together to reinvestigate the first case. The murder of that announcer. And there's a delivery man mentioned right here.
I better go tell Dojima-san!
After resigning from his last job, he took up the family delivery business. Before that, he was a council secretary, Taro Namatame.
The Anka singer's husband!
All we know about him is his occupation, but I'd say that's enough of a lead to tell us where to go next. The address is... it's not far from here.
I give him the clue, and he still finds an excuse to chew me out.
Is he gonna be okay? The killer's not just a normal guy.
Nana-chan!
Adachi-san!
If there's been a break in the case, I'd better hurry to the scene. I'll just have to hope nothing happens here while I'm gone. I didn't see anything.
Adachi-san.
Let's go to Namatame's place. Dojima-san's probably on his way now.
Daddy's coming for you. Shit!
Hey, is that smoke?
An accident? Oh!
Dojima-san! Are you alright?
What? Where's Nanako?
Hello? We need an ambulance! Quickly, there's been an accident. One adult male is injured.
That's right, I should call backup too. We gotta find Namatame.
Nanako. Where's Nanako?
What happened?
Was on my way to Namatame's house when I saw him drive past me. I gave chase and he... Damn it. Where's Nanako? And Namatame. Find them. Please.
But how? Oh yeah, maybe there's clues in the truck.
Wait, you can't! We need to preserve the scene.
Then allow me. If it rains again while we wait, the information we need will be lost regardless.
Look! There really is a TV in there!
Yes, large enough for persons of any size to fit through. I also recovered a diary from the driver's seat, most likely kept by Namatame himself. I learned the existence of a new world, thus I must save people.
Save? The hell's he mean by that?
This... it's a list of the victims' home addresses. Mayumi Yamano, Saki Kanishi, Yukiko Amagi, Kanji Tatsumi, Rise Kujikawa. Even the victims who survived and were never released to the public are written here. I note that Mr. Moraoka's address is absent from the list.
Wow. Then that settles it.
The last date is today's. I can't believe such a small child appeared on it. I must save this child no matter what.
Is that
about Nanako-chan?
I managed to take her to safety. The police have been active lately. This will probably be the last time I write in this diary. I've done everything I can.
It's clear now. He used the same trick on all the victims. He'd just ring the bell like he was making a normal delivery, then throw the victim into the TV in his truck. Namatame is the killer!
We need to go save Nanako-chan. Here, let's use this TV and...
Wait a sec! We don't know where we'll enter through this one. What if we end up somewhere dangerous? It doesn't seem like it's going to be foggy tomorrow, so we should go in tomorrow, the same way as usual.
But...
If we fail, who's going to save Nanako-chan?
Saving her will be our top priority from tomorrow forward. We'll leave Namatame's whereabouts to the police. Dojima-san.
You guys.
Are you all right?
I almost look like hell right now. Nanako, she's my reason for living. If I lose her, I might as well be dead. She must be so scared right now, waiting for someone to save her. And here I am. When she needs me most, I'm helpless. What kind of a father am I? I can't even protect my own daughter.
Dojima-san.
If anything happens to Nanako, I'll make Namatame pay. You can save Nanako, right? I trust you. Please, save her for me. You're the only ones I can turn to right now. Please.
We will rescue Nanako-chan at any cost. It may take some time, but you must put your faith in us and wait for us to return with her.
Nanako-chan's on the other side, right?
Definitely. There's no mistake.
The police should be pursuing Namatame, so let's focus on saving Nanako-chan.
Yeah, we're the only ones who can.
We'll save her, no matter what. I often thought it might be impossible, but we finally cornered the culprit. We made it this far. We won't let him take Nanako-chan's life.
Yeah, this is it. Let's go all out and get it done.
I made a promise with Nana-chan. I said that we'd play again, and that everything would be okay. I promised her that.
Yeah, so let's save her. We're doing it for Dojima-san, too. He'll owe us another watermelon.
Regardless, we must do whatever we can with what we have now. This is something only we can accomplish.
Come on! We can do this, guys! No problem!
Yeah, we do this the same way as always. All we gotta do is find Nanako-chan before the next foggy day and get her out of there. Nothing to it. Let's keep calm, be careful, and get it done. Look at this thick fog.
Does this have something to do with all the fuss about the fog lately?
Something's weird in here. I think all the commotion in town has been affecting this world, too.
Well, we need to hurry now. Rise, can you tell which direction Nanako-chan is in?
I sense her... that way. Wow! What's this warm feeling? Senpai, we need to save her!
Let's go!
Thank you.
is Nanako-chan's? It's so beautiful. It's like a storybook vision of heaven.
Like heaven, huh? Deep down, Nanako-chan must really miss her.
I'm sure she does. She's only a child. We have to do everything in our power to rescue her.
Of course! We're gonna rescue Nana-chan no matter what!
We can find Namatame later and give him what's coming to him then. First, we need to rescue Nanako-chan.
Mom?
That's Nana-chan's voice!
Mom? Where are you? Why did you disappear? Why did you leave me? No! Come back!
Are these Nanako-chan's feelings?
But I'm not lonely. I have Dad with me. I know he's always late coming home, and he never plays with me because he's so busy. He can't cook or do laundry either. He tries to be nice, though he is a little scary sometimes. But I love him. Big Bro is with me now, too. So I'm not alone. I'm not lonely.
Little kid. Telling herself she's not lonely so she doesn't fall apart.
You idiot. We'll ruin everything if we act all sad. We gotta greet her with a smile.
Nana-chan.
What's the matter?
Something's not right. There's someone here besides Nanako-chan. It was faint at first, so I couldn't tell for sure. But there's definitely another person here. And whoever this is, their power's getting stronger.
Could it be Namatame? Did he duck in here after being cornered like Mitsuo?
Perhaps so. It seemed as if he was particularly determined to kidnap Nanako-chan.
But why? If he is the real culprit, he must know the dangers of coming into this world.
I don't know, but if it is him, he may have entered from a TV near the site of the accident. Perhaps even the TV in his truck, which means Nanako-chan may be in grave danger. We must hurry.
Big Bro!
You mustn't go! I'm going to save this girl.
Taro Namatame, it's definitely him. Then he did come in here.
So you're the killer!
Let go of her!
You're the ones I saved. Don't worry, I'll save this girl too.
Huh? Is this dude high or something? Quit talking shit and let go of the girl!
Don't come near me!
Nanako-chan!
Calm down, Kanji-kun. We can't predict his behavior. We have to keep him talking. If we can discern his intentions, perhaps we can somehow deal with him.
To save them. People needing to be saved appear. That's why I put them in the TV.
No, we must pull his attention away from Nanako-chan. You put the people you saw on the Midnight Channel into this world, am I correct?
They all want to be saved.
Did I ever ask you to save me?
You didn't save us, damn it! It was the exact opposite!
If I hadn't put you in the TV, how would you have ended up?
How would we?
Are you trying to say we wouldn't have been able to face ourselves?
What? But we nearly died!
Yes. Exactly.
You kidnapped them. Yes or no?
Yes.
Why did you target local residents who became known through the media? Why do these people appear on the Midnight Channel?
On rainy nights, on TV, they signal me to save them.
You keep saying save this and save that. Are you saying murdering people is your idea of saving them?
Murder? No. I'm saving them.
How's that different, huh? All you're doing is killing people!
If you want to think that, go ahead. I know. You chased us all the way here to kill. Well, too bad. I'm gonna save her.
You asshole! You're not gonna get away with this!
Shut the hell up!
What a wonderful world! An unknown, unreachable place filled with pleasant fog. I'm a savior! It's filthy over there. So many evildoers.
That's why I'm going to save them! I'm a savior! A righteous hero!
Is that a shadow?
Big bro! I can't breathe!
Nana-chan!
Let's do this.
Now, Senpai!
Nana-chan!
Nanako-chan? Nanako-chan! Bastard! How dare you!
Give her back. I'm going to save her!
Anywhere.
This place must not be good for her. We need to carry her out quick.
We should take him with us as well.
Yeah, we can't just leave him here, I guess.
Nanako-chan, hang in there. What are we gonna do?
She's so small. And she was stuck in there for so long. And then there was that weird fog. Damn it!
The police and paramedics will be here shortly.
Nana-chan's still small, so her other self didn't appear like everyone else. And she got caught in all that craziness. I hope she'll be okay.
I mean, are the doctors going to be able to help her?
I'm worried about Nana-chan!
But there's nothing more we can do for her.
A delivery man named Namatame. The possibility of Nanako-chan being targeted, if only I'd been more thorough in putting the facts together, then Nanako-chan wouldn't have had to go through this.
That goes for me too. If I hadn't stood there like a lump in front of that bastard, Nanako-chan might have been okay.
I hate myself. Why do I always panic when it matters most?
I couldn't do anything either.
I should have noticed sooner that something was wrong with that guy.
Why did I waste time listening to what Namatame had to say? If I hadn't tried to engage him in conversation, and we'd rescued Nanako-chan immediately, this wouldn't have happened. But I still...
All right. Enough of this pity party. Is standing around and whining really what we ought to be doing now?
feeling pathetic, consoling each other. That gonna solve anything? We gotta believe in her. So stop rehashing what's already done. Get it together, Naoto!
Sorry. You're absolutely right.
This is all that bastard Namatame's fault. And he's behind bars now, right? And it ain't like we were too late for Nanako-chan.
Yeah, that's true.
I'll come see Nana-chan every day so she'll get better faster!
That's all we can do right now.
Gee, Kanji. You sounded cool for a second there.
Huh? You guys still here?
Adachi-san, did they find out anything?
Dojima-san's speaking with the doctor now, but they can't say anything definite until they run some tests on her. Not just Nanako-chan, but the perp too. Who knows when we'll be able to hear his story. Well, it's getting late, so hurry home. The last thing we need is for you guys to collapse too.
He's right. We should call it a night. Nanako-chan's gonna be fine. Acting all gloomy won't help anything.
When Nanako-chan's out of the hospital, what should we do to celebrate?
Dude, isn't it a little early for that?
Why don't we reserve June S and have a party there?
A party at June S? That makes no sense.
Nana-chan, she'll get better, right? Yeah, I think so too. Let's all have fun with Nana-chan when she comes back. Thanks. I almost forgot how to keep a happy face. But with that out of the way, I'm feeling all hungry. Hey! Where did everyone go? Don't leave without me!
Huh? You didn't go home yet?
I heard. Thanks. Nanako. I'm so relieved.
Dojima-san? You awake? I guess it's no surprise. He was so stressed out over Nanako-chan. I'll stay with him tonight. You can go home and rest, even if it's just for a little while. Oh, please. You look terrible. Nanako-chan's safe, so relax. I think you should get some rest. Hurry and go. Your friends are waiting, aren't they?
Senpai, I thought about it. Why, my mind just went blank when I heard about Konami. I mean, I ran away from showbiz because I was tired of being an idol. So I shouldn't have had any problems. And yet, I felt so angry about it. Why do you think that is? Yeah. You knew all along, huh? But really, that's how it was. Rizet's name in lights, idolized by the masses. That was me, too. I didn't want to lose that me. There's no way to become someone else. I ran away from my plain, gloomy self. Then I ran away from my idol self. Right now, I'm the homicide detective self, I guess. I would have run away from that as well if I didn't realize. I've been trying to become how I wanted to be. I pick a role. When I'm through with it, I continue chasing the real me by picking another role. When in fact, those roles are all me. I don't want to run away anymore. I don't want to search somewhere else for myself. I'm gonna hang in there, as the complete me. I'm glad I came to this town. I'm glad to have met you and the others too.
home, Senpai. I am currently in Senpai's room. Seems quite clean for a boy of his age. There doesn't seem to be anything lying around that he wouldn't want me to see. Now then, where could the goods in question be hiding? I'll ask the man himself. So, where do you hide them? Huh? Oh, I don't... I'm sorry. It's not that I wanted to know. I just got kind of embarrassed, so... You meanie. Senpai, you're leaving in the spring, right? I've made up my mind about something. You see, I'm thinking of going back into showbiz this spring. I am Rizad, after all. And when I consider it that way, I think I can have more fun working. I know how hard it is for a star to make a comeback after an entire year's absence. But even then, I want to start over from the beginning. Do you remember the fan who gave me that letter? I'll do it for her. For my old manager, Inoue-san. For my family, everyone. You. And for myself. Senpai, this... I want you to have it, Senpai. But even then, I signed it Rizette. A Rizette without a fake smile. Senpai, I won't make the same mistake. There's no such thing as a me who isn't me. So I won't run away. I won't try to be someone I'm not. There's a lot of Rises inside me. I won't try to change them. Instead, I'll let people know that those Rises exist. That's the me I want to be. Stronger, thanks to you being with me. Senpai? As long as you're watching me, I'll do my best. So, well, I'm happy doing anything if you're there with me. Well... Oh, come on. I've confessed my love hundreds of times on TV. Why can't I do it in person? I'm sure I can hang in there as long as you're watching me. Because, you're special to me. No matter what I'm doing, I am me. I can say that for sure now. And the strength to say so, it was you who found it for me. I'm going to like the me you found. After all, I like the you who found her. Senpai, I love you. I love you. Senpai, keep watching me so I won't mess up again. Look at me. Well, I've never gone through this kind of thing, so... if we were on a TV set, this would be a wrap. So, what am I supposed to do after this?
And now, the weather. The week ended on a wet note as rain clouds moved into the area. As a result, a thick fog is expected to form in the Inaba region later tonight.
Thank you.
there he is!
Take a look at this. Namatame's in today's paper. So it's finally over.
Yeah, seriously. I wish we could have done it sooner. Isn't the fog kind of thick this morning? And it's so chilly.
It rarely gets this cold in November.
Oh, it's you guys. Perfect timing. I just got a call from the hospital. They said that starting today, it's okay to visit Nanako-chan.
So she's getting a little better! Thank goodness!
Oh, is that today's paper? So you already know about him. Two counts of kidnappings and murder and five counts of attempted murder. Those are serious crimes. I think it'll go down in history as one of the worst sprees in Japan. He's still mentally unstable, but we're slowly piecing together a story. This is still a secret. But I guess it's okay to tell you guys. You know that diary we found? There were entries about Miss Yamano and Miss Konishi in it. Looks like Namatame had been making advances on Miss Konishi.
That son of a bitch!
Well, I'm gonna head to the hospital now. Dojima-san's recovering too, so I need to go over a few things about this case with him.
Yosuke.
Sorry, I'm alright. Namatame's been caught. He can't hurt anyone now. But forget him. Let's all go visit Nanako-chan after school.
Of course!
Let's tell the others once we get to school.
Nanako, everyone's here to see you.
Big bro.
Dojima-san! Ugh, how many times does this make it today? I understand that you're worried about your daughter, but you still need your rest, too.
Sorry.
Are your injuries that bad?
Well, my wounds have just closed up, and it seems I have a couple of fractures as well.
I'm sorry. I'll wheel him back to his room immediately.
What are you apologizing for?
It's almost time for your checkup, so make sure you're back in your room before then.
Big bro. Yeah, I'm so glad.
Her condition is stable for now, but I never thought I'd say this as a doctor, but we still can't figure out the cause of Nanako-chan's symptoms. That's why we can only administer temporary treatments to alleviate her current pains.
But she's not in danger anymore, is she?
She's regained consciousness, but we can't let our guard down yet. All we can do for now is to monitor her condition closely.
Adachi, how's it going with Namatame?
Well, he's awake now, but he's in no condition to tell us anything useful. We only get a little time each day to interrogate him, so we're stuck until his strength recovers.
I see. I should get back to work as soon as possible. Hopefully by then, Nanako will be out of the hospital.
I think Nanako-chan can get more peace and quiet if she stays here. It's so foggy out. And there's been some weird rumors going around. Seems like no one knows why there's so much fog in town.
It's true. The number of patients complaining about fog-related health problems has increased, which is quite unusual. I can't say for sure that it has no effect on the human body. It certainly could be a psychological effect. People's anxiety over the fog could cause problems. But as far as the fog's chemical makeup, Well, that's not my field, so I can only speculate. What concerns me is that transportation of our medical supplies has been delayed due to the fog.
Fog-related health problems. Well, that's just ridiculous. Anyone who says that is just blowing smoke.
Isn't this weather strange? How could it be lasting so long?
I've never seen anything like it.
I wonder what's causing it. It's so creepy. I heard that a friend of mine's son got sick from the fog and collapsed. You know how sensitive children are to that sort of thing.
I heard something too. They say an old man was driving through the fog and got into an accident.
What? Did he lose control?
Well, he'd never been in an accident or even gotten a ticket before, so something seems off. Isn't that scary?
I've even heard there are experts saying it's poisonous. I wonder if that's true.
Do you think it's, you know, because of that global warming thing? This town's changed a lot over the years. I wish the government would step in and do something about this.
Oh, I agree completely. If we're going to pay taxes, I expect the authorities to do their jobs.
This fog is poison! It's a gas filled with viruses! Don't inhale the fog, or you'll die!
He's not the first one like that I've seen lately.
Poisonous gas, though?
Oh, I'm sure it's not true.
Oh.
Is something wrong?
Oh my. I think I'm coming down with something.
You can't be serious. Oh, that's right. I needed to do some grocery shopping. Well then.
Business has been so slow lately.
Man, this fog just won't quit. The weather report said it might start snowing soon. But what's going to happen if it snows with all this fog?
Whoa! Where'd you guys come from?
Wow, that's quite a crowd you got there.
We ran into each other back there, so we came together. The fog's so thick that sometimes you can't see your nose in front of your face, so everyone's forming groups now.
It's definitely been weird lately. It's so cold, too.
Visibility's so bad, it's scary. Can I stick close to you, Senpai? Oh, this girl never changes.
It really is hard to see anything in this, though. It's just like on the other side.
Guys, put on your glasses!
Whoa, it's all clear.
What the hell's going on?
These glasses are meant to help us see through the fog in the other world. But putting that aside, no glasses would improve one's visibility in a fog under normal circumstances.
Then, could the fog from over there be leaking into our world? Huh? Well, you guys think that's it? I was kind of expecting you to ignore it as Chie being random again. It's just a thought.
Anyways, today's the last day of exams, right? Let's get them over with so we can meet up at the special headquarters after school.
Wow, we haven't used that name in a while.
Thank you.